Angular HTTP resource can validate or transform the response before it's stored in the resource. This is developer-defined behavior. The second argument is an option subject. One of its options is parse. The parse option must be a function. This parameter receives the response from the request. This is not the original response and has already been processed by Angular. By default, a JSON string is parsed, for example, into an object. When using HTTP resource subfunctions, data is parsed into a string, a blob, or an array buffer. The value returned by this function becomes the resource value. Let's add a user ID to use on the URL. We can use this function to transform the response into a new value. The return type defines the resource value type. This new value can be based on the response, or created from scratch. We can also use this parse function for validation. This helps ensure received data matches a required schema. If validation fails, we must report an error to notify this resource. As a result, the status property of this resource becomes error, and the error property contains this error message. A simple way to validate data is by using libraries like Zot or Valibot. Let's see how Zot works. To start, we need to install and import Zot. Next, we define a Zot schema for the expected data structure. Using a component property for this schema is just one possible way. Now we pass the schemas method to the parse option. HTTP resource now uses Zot for validation. Specifying a type for HTTP resource is recommended to improve type safety. I use this interface just for example.